Hello everyone. In last few lectures, we have already learned the mathematical averages, that is arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean. Now in today's lecture, we are going to learn the first positional average. Name is median.
Median is the middlemost observation which divides the data into two equal parts when data arranged in ascending or descending order. Simply, median means middlemost observation of our data. The first, we need to arrange the data in ascending or descending order for calculating the median. For example, suppose my data set is 1, 5, 2. So what is the median? For finding median, we need to arrange the data in ascending or descending order first. So see, ascending order data is 1, 2, 5. So which one is the median here? 2 is the median, because 2 is the middlemost observations. So median is the middlemost observations which divide the data into two equal parts when data arranged in ascending or descending order. Now see case 1 for ungrouped data. So how to calculate median? So formula is n plus 1 divided by 2th observation when data arranged in ascending or descending order, where small n is number of observation. Now see example 4, 45, 60, 48, 100, 65. So calculate the median for given data. So for calculating median, we need to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. So here the ascending order data is 48, 60, 65, 100 and 445. And here the value of n is, that means the number of observations is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and last is 5. Okay, so formula for calculating median is n plus 1 divided by 2th observations when data arranged in ascending or descending order. We already arranged the data in ascending order. Now just plug the value of n is equal to 5 in the formula. So n is 5. So 5 plus 1 divided by 2th observation. So 5 plus 1, that is 6. 6 divided by 2th observation. So 6 divided by 2, that is 3rd observation. So see, the third observation in given series of data is 65. So our median value is 65. So now see the second example. Calculate the median for this given data. Data is 45, 60, 50, 100, 65 and last is 40. So for calculating median, we need to arrange the data in ascending or descending order first. So here the ascending order data is 40, then 45, then 50, then 60, then 65 and last is 100. And here n value is 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 observations we are given in example. So what is the formula for calculating the median? So formula is n plus 1 divided by 2th observation when data arranged in ascending or descending order. Now just plug the value of n is equal to 6 in formula. So 6 plus 1 divided by 2th observation, that means 7 divided by 2th observation. So 7 divided by 2 means 3.5 observation. So how to calculate 3.5th observation? So see, 3.5 is written as 3 plus 0.5. So how to calculate 3.5th observation? First write down the first observation, so first digit. So first digit is 3, so third observation plus 0.5, remaining part as it is, in bracket. After the third observation, there is the fourth observation. So fourth observation minus third observation. This is the method for calculating the 3.5th observation. So 3.5 is written as 3 plus 0.5. So first digit is 3. So third observation plus remaining part 0.5. Then in bracket, after the third observation, there is the fourth observation. So fourth minus the before, that is third observation. Now just plug the value in the formula. Here the third observation is 50, so just plug 50, then 0.5 as it is in bracket. So which one is the fourth observation? 60. So 60 minus third observation is 50. So 60 minus 50 is 10. Now just plug, write down in the next step. So 50 plus 0.5 into 10, then 0.5 into 10 is 5. So 50 plus 5, that is 55. This is the median for given series of data. Okay, now the next is case 2 for group data. So how to calculate median for group data? So step 1 is calculate LCF. What is LCF? Less than cumulative frequency. We already learned how to calculate LCF in previous lectures. Now step 2, calculate capital N divided by 2. What is capital N? Capital N is total frequency. And third step, see the LCF just greater than N divided by 2, then corresponding value of X is median. Now see example. The given example is X along with their frequency, X and frequency, that means group data. Group data means if you are given the X values along with their frequency, then called as the group data. So for calculating median for group data, we need to calculate LCF first. So how to calculate LCF? What is the first frequency value? 2. So write down first frequency value as it is 2. Then first LCF value plus second frequency value. So 2 plus 5, that is 7. So second LCF value is 7. Then 7 plus 7, that is 14. Then 14 plus 13, that is 27. Then 27 plus 21, that is 48. 48 plus 6, that is 54. Then 54 plus 8, that is 62. Then 62 plus 3, that is 65. So this is the method for calculating the LCF, that is less than cumulative frequency. So first step is completed. Now the second step is calculate capital N divided by 2. What is capital N? Capital N is total frequency, that means the sum of column of F. So here the capital N, that means the total of all values of frequencies is 65. So second step for calculating median is calculate capital N divided by 2. So capital N divided by 2, just plug the value of capital N is equal to 65 in the formula. So 65 divided by 2, that is 32.5. Now the last step, see the LCF just greater than N divided by 2 is equal to 32.5. So here which LCF value is just greater than 32.5? So here the 48 LCF value is just greater than 32.5. So the corresponding value of X is median. So here the X is equal to 22.5 is median. Okay. Now see the third case for continuous data. How to calculate median for continuous data? Say step 1, calculate LCF, that means less than cumulative frequency. Now the second step is calculate capital N divided by 2, where capital N is total frequency. Now the third step is see the LCF just greater than capital N divided by 2, then corresponding value of, not value, the corresponding class is median class. So what is the formula for calculating median? L plus capital N divided by 2 minus CF upon F into H, where L is lower limit of a class, F is the frequency of class, H is the class width of a median class, then CF is the LCF before that median class. Okay. Now see example. Calculate median for the following data. The data we are given, the classes along with their frequency, that means the continuous data. So calculate median. So first step to find out the median for continuous data is first calculate LCF, that is less than cumulative frequency. So here the first frequency value is 12, so write down 12 as it is. then 12 plus 22, that is 34, then 34 plus 28, that is 62, then 62 plus 38, that is 100, then 100 plus 37, that is 137, then 137 plus 29, that is 166, then 166 plus 20, that is 186, then 186 plus 14, that is 200. So this is the LCF values. Now the second step is calculate capital N divided by 2. Here the capital N is total frequency, that means sum of all the values of frequencies. So 12 plus 22 plus 28 plus 38 plus 37 plus 29 plus 20 plus 14 is equal to 200. So here the capital N is 200. Now the second step for calculating median for continuous data is calculate capital N divided by 2. Here capital N is 200. So 200 divided by 2, that is 100. Now see the LCF just greater than capital N divided by 2 is equal to 100. So here which LCF is just greater than 100? Remember, just greater than 100, not equal to 100, just greater than 100. So here the LCF 137 is just greater than 100. So the corresponding class is median class. So our median class is 8 to 10. Okay. Now the formula for calculating the median is L plus capital N divided by 2 minus CF upon F into H. Now what is the L? L is the lower limit of median class. So our median class is 8 to 10. So lower limit is 8. Now F is the frequency of median class. So our median class is 8 to 10. So frequency of median class is 37. Now H is the class width of median class. Median class is 8 to 10. So how to calculate the class width? Upper limit minus lower limit. So 10 minus 8, that is 2. Okay, and the CF means the LCF before median class. So which LCF value is before median class? Our median class is 8 to 10. So LCF before median class is 100. So CF value is 100. And capital N divided by 2 value is 100. Now just plug all the values in the formula. L is 8, N divided by 2 is 100, CF is 100, F is 37 and H is 2. So 100 minus 100, that is 0. 0 divided by anything is 0, and 0 into 2, that is 0. So 8 plus 0, that is 8. So our median value is 8. Remember that median is always lies between median class. Our median class is 8 to 10. So median value is 8. That means it lies between the class 8 to 10. Now see how to calculate median value by graphically. To find out the median value by graphically, used ogive curves. There are two types of ogive curves. One is less than ogive curve and second is more than ogive curve. Used either any one. Here I am using the less than ogive curve. How to draw the less than ogive curve? Take upper limit, that is upper class boundary on x axis, and LCF on y axis, and the plot the points on xy plane and join these points by the smooth curve called as the less than ogive curve. So first find out the LCF and upper class boundary. Okay, so upper class boundary means upper limits for each class. That means the classes are in exclusive form. The one condition is there. Okay, so the first class is 0 to 2. Then second is 2 to 4. Then 4 to 6. The given classes is already in exclusive form. Okay, so what is the upper limit for the first class? 2. Okay, that means the upper class boundary for the first class is 2. Then next 4. Then 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 and last is 16. Now take upper limits on x axis and the LCF on y axis and plot the points on xy plane. So for first upper class boundary 2, what is the LCF value? 12. So for 2 it's 12. Then for 4 it's 34. So 34. Then for 6 it's 62. Then for 8 it's 100. Then for 10 it's 137. Then for 12 it's 166. Then for 14 it's 186 and last is for 16 it's 200. So this is the points plotted on xy plane. Now join these points by the smooth curve. join these points by the smooth curve. Then how to calculate median by using the less than or greater curve? So here the capital N value is 200. We need to calculate capital N divided by 2 for finding the median value. Here capital N is 200. So 200 divided by 2, that is 100. See this point 100 on y-axis. So here the 100, okay, point on y-axis. Now draw the horizontal line and the point touches on the curve. Plot the perpendicular bisector on x-axis. Wherever the point this line touches on the x-axis is the median. So here the median value is 8. So by using formula and by using the graph, our median value is 8. So this is the method for finding the median value by graphically. Now next is the merits and demerits of median. First of all, we see merits of median. First merit is it is simple to understand and easy to calculate. Second is it is calculated by graphically, that means by using the Ogier curves. It is least affected by extreme observations because the median is the middlemost observation. So suppose the data is 1, 2, 3. So median is 2. So it is least affected by that extreme observation. Suppose my data is 1, 2, 30. So which one is the median? 2. So median is the least affected by the extreme observation. Median is just nothing but the middlemost observation. Now the next merit is it is calculated for qualitative data and for the open-end classes. Okay, now the demerits of median is it is not based on all observation. Yes, because it just depends on the middlemost observations for ungrouped data and group data case. And for continuous data, it just depends on the median class and pre-median class, because we need the LCF value for pre-median class. Okay, next demerit is it is not rigidly defined, because it is not depends on all observations, so not strictly defined. And if it is not rigidly defined, then it is not capable for further mathematical treatment. These are the merits and demerits of median. In next lecture, we will see the next measure of central tendency, name is quartiles. Thank you.